Greetings. I'm Goldline. I'm back with a part two, speaking of the divine masculine and divine feminine energy, a channeled message. Now, I do want to let you all know, sometimes I go into talking and I forget. This is for whoever resonate with this message. Okay, if it don't apply, let it fly. Okay, I'm channeling a lot of divine feminine and divine masculine energies of what's going on. So for the collective, I get on here and let you guys know. Okay, also feathers are significant to someone, because I've been fanning feathers like every other day. So it's really good. It's a good vibration. You're moving in the right direction. You're flying high. You are being guided by a higher power. And keep moving forward. Keep being great, okay? Don't let whatever you're experiencing, whether it's pain, just be thankful for the bad times and the good times, basically, okay? We have to be grateful for them all, because that's what makes us who we are, okay? Excuse me. So, Divine Feminine, just a message for you all. Make sure that you do some twin flame healing, okay? A lot of you all are really intuitive and you're doing the work, so you know what you're doing. But if you need my assistance, I will be glad to help you and let you know some good techniques and pointers that will help you heal your heart space, okay? Very intense. I always say this. I'm continue to say this. Very intense connection. Okay. And for a person to keep on repeatedly hurting you, even being non-expressive, emotional withdrawal, it's also a very low vibrating energy. And that frequency can also cause a lot of damage on your heart. You know, just think, if you've been expressive with someone and they don't know how to emotionally express themselves to you, that's a really hurtful situation, because you don't know how they feel, you know. So that's a really low vibration to be in, when a person does not know how to express themselves, okay? Because you don't know really what they're thinking, especially if you're new on your journey. Now, for me, I'm very intuitive, okay? I have really strong psychic gifts, okay? So, I can read how a person feels from my intuition. But I'm not going to continue on to let my intuition speak for them. They're going to have to open their mouth and speak for themselves. Or if not, then it'll end up being a non-communication. And I will usually like walk away, you know, from it. I am known, I'm Aquarius rising. If you don't know, I will walk away quickly from a situation. But the ancestors told me, you know, this is for who this resonates with, that I need to start staying and fighting if I want something. You know, just don't walk away so easily. But it's like, when you're a person that experienced a lot in your lifetime, it's like you go wherever, you navigate where that peace is. And if you can't get that peace after a while, you like, you gone. And that's how basically I am. I'm strictly for peace and adventures. You know, that's all I want to do. Peace and adventures, heal the world, and have a damn ball. Like, I don't like drama. I don't like stagnant. I don't like none of that. I just love to have fun, to be free, you know, and do what I can do to help individuals. That's all. And love. That's all. That's how my heart is, you know. So when I'm put in a situation where it's constant going against the opposite of what that I like, you know, like it's conflict. It's like it make me want to just quickly, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm not on it. I feel like all my life, majority of my life, I've dealt with that. So now it's like it's time for me to experience the luxury, abundant life full of just strictly just love. Everybody that's coming my way is for my best interest, and we gonna have a damn ball together, because that's what it's about. That's what I want to do. We gonna have a ball. Everything else is irrelevant, you know. So that's what I like to mainly focus on. I focus on the good. I focus on the peace. I focus on the clarity. Anything else, it don't do anything for me, okay? I like to be on a high vibrational, happy, peaceful frequency. And when I got on here, if you guys been watching me, I told y'all, like, all my pages, people be on my pages, stop trying to stop my messages. And when I did the first video, it was like somebody tried to change my passcode. But see, I got it fixed up on here where it comes to my phone, so you could tell they tried to change it, but it didn't work, because like I said, I got it set up on my phone. So when somebody try to change it, it's gonna boop, boop, it's gonna contact me, you know. But it's like, I'm going to get this message out here. I'm going to continue to shine my light and to shine my love all over this universe, because that's what I'm here for. I'm here for that, and people need me, and I know. Okay, almost every other day, the ancestors wake me up and let me know, you know. And not only that, I know it, because it's like the things that I know that's coming to me, I have seen it already. And it's because I do have a higher calling because of what I encountered in my life. I know that. And I envisioned these dreams a long time ago, and now it's coming into fruition. Okay? It's coming in. And it was like this specific girl. And she's a beautiful brown skin girl about my complexion. And she's been with the guy that she with for a long time. And I don't know why, I always thought they was a beautiful couple. And when I seen her and her happiness and her relationship, Spirit was telling me, like, that's going to be you and your divine masculine. And every time I see them, I mean, they just like, they in the spotlight. When you see them, they both glowing, like, she looking all good and she shining. And she glowing, and he right next to her, matching her flag. And I just love him. I used to just love watching him and laughing, because I'm like, this is beautiful. Unconditional love is beautiful. So I just want to get on here and let you guys know, divine masculine and divine feminine. You divine feminine, if it's not going to work, take what resonates, move on, be great, but don't stop loving. You know, if I not with my divine masculine, I know that I'm still going to be happy either way it goes. And I also am still going to want the best for him, and I'm going to want him to be happy as well. Okay? So either way it goes, I want us both to win for our situation, and it goes for far as the collective situation. Whatever the outcome is with you divine masculine and divine feminine connections, okay, all chemical balances, I just wish the best that you be happy. You know, because that's what all some of us look for, especially if we have a higher calling. That's all we want, is to encounter that love, that unconditional love that some of us never had, you know. And the ancestors know. They know, and they're going to give it to you, whether it's your divine masculine or divine feminine. Someone's going to come and sweep you off your feet. So get ready. Get ready. And be happy until they come. Self-love all over you. From your head to your toes. Self-love. Take yourself out on dates. Take yourself out on clubs, party, dance. Do whatever fulfill and make your spirit happy. Okay? I'm Golden Light, and I'm always here to shed light. I just wanted to put that message on here. Peace, love, light, and also darkness.